white men can't jump. To quote with artistic license, Mr. Sidney Dean, I don't mean to brag, but this film is the greatest.
It hurts so bad. Oh, hey, baby, let me tell you something. I don't mean to brag, but I'm the greatest. I am the greatest.
White Men Can't Jump must feature in any serious auteur's top 10 sports movies of all time. The MVP of 1992, if you will. The film is centered around two protagonists, a slow, white, geeky chump in Woody Harrelson.
Chump, I'm talking to you. What, you deaf or something? Talking to the fucking air.
My name ain't Chump, it's Billy Hoyle.
Billy Hoyle.
And in contrast, a smooth, wily, artful dodger in Wesley Snipes, who exudes Muhammad Ali confidence throughout.
I picked the worst fucking player here for $500. Excuse me? Huh? Excuse me? I let you pick my teammate.
They fabricate a partnership, rather fortunately due to the inner city's dismissive disdain for white basketball players. The two hustle and plot their way through the dilapidated basketball courts of Venice Beach and their own personal rocky relationships.
Raymond, man, look at the chump, man. Give him the chump. Oh, no, hell no. See, white boys don't count. No, you have to give me a brother.
No. You got him, the goofy-looking guy.
Me?
Yeah, you. Aw. I'm fucked.
Hey, chump. Ron Shelton's ability as writer and director to weave in a stereotypical joke without a severe racist undertone and not let race bear any relevance to the outcome or narrative is a masterstroke.
Oh, you like to listen. That's what the fucking problem is. Y'all listen.
Well, what am I supposed to do, eat it?
No. You're supposed to hear it.
Hey, I just said I like to listen to it,
man. No. There's a difference between hearing and listening. See, white people, y'all can't hear Jimmy. You listen.
What the fuck are you talking about? His drummer was white.
Get the fuck out of here. Jimi Hendrix's drummer was not white.
Yes, he did. Yo, check it out. See?
This is a picture.
Whole damn band is white except for Jimmy.
This is a fucking picture.
While some critics thought the movie was a slam dunk, the other half held the common ideology that the film was a brick and did not make an enlightening point on race.
I'm in the fucking zone. They're pissed off. I'm in the zone.
Billy, this is not about black and white. This is about money. This is about green. You got that? Look, man, I need this $5,000. And I am not about to let you blow this for me. No fucking way.
You pissed off?
To me, that is the exact point as to why the movie triumphed. It does not hang its hat on race. It merely leans into it for comedy value, without ever really offending any color or creed.
Because you ain't good enough.
Oh, is that another brother thing, huh?
No,
you fucking racist?
No, there's certain things you can do and there's certain things you can't.
I can hear Jimmy.
No.
I can hear Jimmy.
No.
Yes, I can.
You can't hear
Jimmy. Fuck you.
No, you can't hear Jimmy.
Fuck you.
The film will always be remembered for its crisp and efficient script. The insults, the biting dialogue, and let's not forget the your mama jokes. Nonetheless, in my view, the real reason the box office taking soared to $90 million is the palpable chemistry between two of Hollywood's most charming actors, Harrelson and Snipes.
What the fuck are you doing?
Hey, I'm doing two things.
What? What are you doing?
I'm making them mad. Most guys don't play good when they're mad.
Look, you know you're embarrassing me. That's what you're doing.
Yeah, well, that's the other thing I'm doing.
I can't believe this. You know, you're not embarrassing me. You are pissing me off. That's what you're doing.
Well, good, because unlike those guys, I assume you play better when you're mad. Am I right?
I'm not listening to you.
Yeah, but you are hearing me.
Post the movie's release and their newfound widespread notoriety, Shelton noted that they would no longer be known as the other guy in Mo Better Blues and the seventh lead on Cheers.
Patterson!
Came as soon as we could.
Hey, man, we heard it over the scanner. Woo, man, what a mess. Look, if there's anything that we can do to help, just...
All you gotta do is ask.
Snipes continued the lover affair, quoting, I made a lifelong friend in Woody and a spiritual brother.
Come on, man. We just want to help, okay?
We're trying to help you.
The bromance continued into the 90s with the actors taking up similar roles in the 1995 buddy movie Money Train.
This is what I think of you, you fuck up.
Hey, my face?
Whoa. No. Hey, you're going to hit it.
Why not?
Because I'm going to hit it.
No, you're not going to hit it. We both hit it.
Not that I'm suggesting Harrelson and Snipes were method acting, but it is said the hustling and scheming would continue long after shooting was done for the day. Snipes placed a wager with Harrelson that white men could indeed not jump.
Man, you were almost there. Almost there.
Harrelson would fail day on day to dunk. With the shoot ending, Harrelson sought help from the set crew and had the hoop lowered to any eye-defying 9.5 feet.
Is this shit regulation? This shit ain't regulation.
He finally managed to slam home and win his wager.
Yo, move out the way, man. I'll check it for you. Move out the way. That's about right. Let's go, baby.
Ron Shelton made it compulsory that any actor auditioning for the role had to shoot some hoops with him before they even read. Keanu Reeves was just one of those actors that fell by the wayside after matching up Shelton. He quoted on Keanu, "He was a hard worker, but not a basketball player." Contrary to that quote and the fact the studio wanted Denzel Washington, Shelton couldn't overlook Wesley Snipes for the role of Sidney.
It's all right, Walter, why don't you throw that big fat butt at me, huh? I'm getting tired of making you look bad, Walter. It's hard work, hard goddamn work for another man to make another man look so bad.
Man, I'm fitting a dog.
He showed up with more attitude and less jump shot than anybody. He walked on the court trash-talking, and it didn't matter if he had any game.
All right, Walter, you got the pill, what you gonna do? And you're gonna shoot it because you know I knock it out the fucking sky.
Uh-huh.
And you ain't gonna take it to the hole, Walter, because you ain't good enough, Walter.
You think so?
I know
so.
I don't think...
Snipes did not dispute this assessment, but in true Sidney Dean fashion, retorted, "Every time I shot it, even if it didn't go in, I talked like it did. I made you believe that you were lucky it didn't go in."
That shit went out like a Scud missile. Oh, it hurts.
With Nike making trainers inspired by the characters and Atari Corporation releasing video games based on the film, White Men Can't Jump could have been a real cash cow for 20th Century Fox. However, a bitter legal dispute between the studio and Shelton quashed any ideas of sequels or Netflix series. Shelton sued the studio for profits owed from the movie and won a settlement of $9,800,000.
Who's this?
Sidney Dean.
So?
Right on. You know, your boyfriend here, he took some money from me today, and I just happened to notice this bottle.
Oh, you take that shit and shoot your ass.
Honey, what's up with you, man? No, baby, you need to chill with some of the caffeine, all right?
Excuse me? You comfortable?
Nah, but you know, futon is actually better for your back.
This movie does not pretend to have a core principle or virtues. It is not a documentary on two-on-two pickup games. Shelton identifies that fringes of sports are where the most entertaining action can be found.
You, my friend, are shooting for the Sudan. Huh? Yeah. And a hook shot.
And a hook shot.
Hook shot.
Don't look at me. Look, it's their court, it's their rules. You're on your own.
Any fringe that includes Woody Harrelson and Wesley Snipes on screen together, take my money.
Can I use my right arm?